I'm Bernard Parks, Councilman, 8th District, and you're watching VideoWebb.
This is H.P. Barnum. I'm watching VideoWebb.
I'm Councilwoman Jan Perry, and you're watching VideoWebb.
My name is Howard Biggin, and you are watching VideoWebb.
William Allen Young with Brad Pye Jr., the honor of the evening. You're watching VideoWebb.
I'm Brad Pye Jr. You are watching VideoWebb. Switch reels.
I am a mountain, I am a tall tree, oh, I am a swift wind, sweeping the country. I am a river, down in the valley, oh, I am a vision, and I can see clearly. If anybody asks you who I am, just stand up tall, look them in the face and say, I'm that star up in the sky, I'm that mountain peak up high. Hey, I made it, I'm the world's greatest. And I'm that little bit of hope, when my back's against the ropes, I can feel it, I'm the world's greatest. I am a giant, I am an eagle, oh, I am a lion, down in the jungle. I am a marching band, I am the people, oh, I am a heaven hand, I am a hero. If anybody asks you who I am, just stand up tall, look them in the face and say, I'm that star up in the sky, I'm that mountain peak up high. Hey, I made it, I'm the world's greatest. And I'm that little bit of hope, when my back's against the ropes, I can feel it, I'm the world's greatest.
In the ring of life, I'll reign love,
I will reign,
and the world will know that I am.
Oh yeah,
yeah. Oh, it's dark, it's shine a light,
shine a light.
And there's a success in me,
in me.
Oh, it's dark, it's shine a light. And there's a success in me.
Said I made it,
I'm the world's greatest.
From that little bit,
is finally mine today. I guess I'm just a lucky guy, and here I'm about to tell you why. It
It's strictly on account of my sweet potato pie. The fella that she loved the most, the main reason why she left the coast. She's my little girl, senior, so much hotter than a hallelujah. As tender as a night in June, sweeter than a honeymoon, brighter than a silver spoon, just about as crazy as a loon. Softer than a lullaby, deeper than the midnight sky, soulful as a baby's cry.
That's my
sweet potato pie. Around the neighborhood, I wonder how she grew up so good. She belonged to Freddy and he was bad, and I never was ready to make him mad. Oh no. But I'm glad I had to wait a while, a little bit too juvenile. I needed to refine my style, a silk suit, a crocodile smile.
Let the whole damn world go by, cause I just wanna testify. From now on it's me and mine,
sweet potato pie.
Yeah. Oh, yeah now, my sweet potato pie. Yeah, yeah. Oh, I love this, I love it.
Tastin' so sweet and yeah,
yeah. Oh, this girl is all right.
Go ahead, baby. Sweet potato pie now. Yeah.
Oh,
you get your fill to eat, but always keep that hunger. May you never take one single breath for granted. God forbid love ever leave you empty-handed. I hope you still feel small when you stand beside the ocean. Whenever promise me that you'll give faith a fighting chance, and when you get the choice to sit it out or dance, I hope you dance. I hope you dance. I hope you never feel those mountains in the distance. Settle for the path of least resistance. Living might mean taking chances, but they're worth taking. Loving might be a mistake, but it's worth making. Don't let choice to sit it out or dance. I hope you did. Whenever one door closes, I hope one more opens. Promise me that you'll give faith a fighting chance. And when you get the choice to sit it out or dance.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Coconut Grove. Tonight we present those fabulous ABC recording artists, Bobby Bland and B.B. King.
You ready, Bob?
All right.
Time, I know good you're on my
party.
Yeah.
That BB and Bob is in town. I got a dollar and a quarter.
Well,
and I'm just wearing a clown. Don't let nobody play me cheap.
I got 50 cents and all that. I'm gonna keep it right.
Treasure.
got to black cowboy. What's that, man? Dang, can't I do it too, man? Oh, okay, man.
That's what they do, man.
See, Larry's filming you, man. See, Larry's filming you, man.
He filming me live.
That's your boy.
Well, look, you got to do it right. Yeah. Come on, Mike. No, you got to do it right now. This is legend right here.
That's right.
Brad Pye has been my friend. Worked for me for 30 years taking pictures.
I used to listen to him on the radio all the time.
Where's the picture? You late. You late. Get down here. Deadline.
Okay. Get this one.
Okay, wait a minute, hold on. Okay, do it again. Here we go.
Got it. All right, then one looking up, one looking up just here, regular looking at me. Just like that. There's one. Here's two. Lady in the back, come up a little bit. Yeah, yeah, feel that spot. And that's great. Here's one. Here's two.
Now all you ladies kissing. All of you.
Why you wanted that pie?
Yeah.
That was good.
Recession, depression, and unemployment. This song's for you.
Today's a new day, but there is no sunshine. Nothing but clouds, and it's dark in my heart, and it feels like a cold night. Today's a new day, but where are my blue skies? Where is the love and the joy that you promised me? Tell me it's alright.
I'll be honest with you,
I almost gave up, but a power that I can't explain fell from heaven like a shower. Now,
when I think how much better I'm gonna be when this is over,
I smile. Even though I hurt, see I smile. I know God is working, so I smile. Even though I've been here for a while,
what you do?
I smile.
Come on,
smile. It's so hard to look up when you've been down. Sure would hate to see you give up now.
God's people,
you look so much better when you smile. So smile.
Now every day ain't gonna be perfect, but it's still on me. Today don't have purpose. Come on.
Today's a new day, but there is no sunshine. Nothing but clouds, and it's dark in my heart, and it feels like a cold night.
It ain't easy, but
today's a new day. But tell me, where are my blue skies?
Where is that love, y'all?
Where is the love and the joy that you promised me? Tell me it's alright.
The truth is,
I almost gave up a power that I can't explain.
That Holy Ghost power, y'all,
fell from heaven like a shower down.
And I know we've been hurt, y'all, but still,
I smile.
Come on.
Even though I hurt, see, I smile.
Y'all feel that?
I know God is working, so I smile. Even though I've been here for a while,
still,
I smile.
Hallelujah.
I smile. It's so hard to look up when you've been down. Sure would hate to see you give up now.
God's people,
you look so much better when you smile.
Let's go.
Smile for me.
Whoa.
Can you just smile for me?
Whatever you're in right now.
Smile for me.
Smile.
Can you just smile for me?
And my people say,
oh, oh, oh. You look so much better when you're oh-oh-oh. You look so much better when you're
oh-oh-oh.
You look so much better when you're oh-oh-oh.
You look so much better when you're
oh-oh-oh. And while you're waiting,
you look so much better
when you're oh-oh-oh. And while you're praying, you look so much better when you're
oh-oh-oh. Look in the mirror,
you look so much better when you're oh-oh-oh.
Always remember,
you're watching VideoWebb.
I almost gave up.
That I can't
explain. But that Holy Ghost power, y'all,
fell from heaven,
came
like
down from heaven. Hardships, difficulties,
right now,
tears, storms, this is what I do.
I smile.
Woo!
Even though I hurt, see, I smile.
Boy, that feels good.
I know God is working, so I smile.
All things are working.
Even though I've been here for a while,
still,
I smile.
Hallelujah.
It's so hard to look up when you've been down.
I know it's hard right now.
Sure would hate to see you give up now.
Because you're a winner.
You look so much better when you smile.
You look better.
So smile.
Oh, oh, oh. Dallas.
You look so much better when you're
New Orleans.
You look so much better when you're
Come on. Cleveland.
You look so much better when you're
Detroit.
You look so much better when
you're
Philly. You look so much better when you're
Jersey!
you to be happy, then you gotta have something happen. I want you to have joy, cause can't nobody take that from you. I see you smiling. Y'all want some more? Y'all want some more of that? Are y'all sure y'all want some more of that?
Okay,
look this way, right here. Look at me. One, two, three.
And I never thought I'd feel this way. And as far as I'm concerned, I'm glad I got the chance to say that I do believe I love you. And if I should ever go away, well then close your eyes and try to feel the way we do today. And then if you can remember, keep smiling, keep shining, knowing you can always count on me. For sure, that's what friends are for. For good times and bad times, I'll be on your side forevermore.
Here's two. The bad boy swinging.
diddly dee.
Oh, yeah.
I'm still a little
chewy. Oh, well, all right. Oh, yeah. The bad boy is swinging. Well, all right.
Diddly dee, diddly dee, diddly
dee. Oh, yeah. Well, all right.
The bad boy is swinging.
That's my heart.
Roll back the rug, everybody. All the tables and chairs. We're gonna have us a good time tonight. Every time that we meet, we skip and we dip to the beat. Yeah. What in the world could be better than getting together? Yeah. The last time we party. It ended when the sun came up. That's why your mama told you that you couldn't go out.
Stay in the house.
Bad boy. Gonna sneak out tonight. He's gonna take by her window. Cause he sure wants to go out and. Everyone's here, let them all in.
Oh, yeah.
The chandelier downstairs has fallen.
Well, all right.
I know it's hard to resist. This is the party no one wanted to miss. If you don't get home on the double,
oh, yeah.
You're going to be in trouble.
Well, all right.
I hope your mama don't look in your room. Cause if she does, she'll be here soon.
Boy.
She's gonna be mad. You're a bad boy. You got it bad.
Boy.
Say goodbye to your friends. Cause
it's gonna be a while till you see them again.
Bad boy. I'll sneak out tonight. He's gonna tip by her window. Cause he sure wants to get out and dance.
Yeah. Oh,
cause everyone's singing.
Dancing to the music.
On the radio.
See the bad boy having a party.
Everybody's singing.
He's a bad boy dancing to the music.
On the radio.
No,
no, no, no, no. You can't go. Bad boy.
Ooh, bad boy.
He's gotta sneak out tonight. Cause it shows the guy.
Ooh, yeah.
Yeah. Oh. Everybody
singing. Yeah. Dancing to the music.
By her window. Really, really deep.
Put your hand on the shoulder, sir. Okay, here we go, Brad. Looking right here, looking at me. Here's one. Look at it.
You're watching VideoWebb.
Inside your heart, you don't have to be afraid of what you are. There's an answer if you reach into your soul, and the sorrow that you know will melt away. Comes along with the strength to carry on, and you cast your fears aside, and you know you can survive. So when you feel like hope is gone, look inside you and be strong, and you'll finally see the truth that a hero lies in you.
Till the sun goes down, I've been got you by my side. Wouldn't have it any other way. Just wanna tell you how I'm feeling inside. Like I've been walking cloud number 9. Your love is rare and like the finest of wine. It just gets better with time. Said it just gets better with time. Can't stop thinking about you, love. Got to have you around me. I live for the moments when we touch. Such a sensation I can't explain. Just wanna tell you how I'm feeling inside. But you got me walking on cloud number 9. Your love is rare and like the finest of wine. Said it just gets better with time.
It just gets
keeps on getting better.
My friend, I feel whatever you want to do is all right with me. Cause you make me feel so brand new. Want to spend my life with you. Me say it seems, baby, since we've been together. Loving you forever is what I need. Let me be the one you come running to. I'll never be untrue. Oh, baby, let's stay together. Loving you well. Times are good and bad, happy or sad. Ooh, yeah. Well, the times are good and bad, happy or sad. Why somebody? People break up, oh, and turn around and make up. I just came to see you'd never do that to me, would you, baby? It's being around you is all I see. Is what I want to do. And we ought to stay together. Loving you well, well. Times are good and bad, happy or sad. Come on, baby.
Brad Davis was the greatest man in the world. I coached Dorsey 8 years. They went undefeated 8 straight years. I was inducted in the Hall of Fame with Billie Jean King at Cal State University. I beat Arthur Ashe when Ashe first came out to UCLA. I played for 9 NCAA section titles. I won 5 of them. I was a runner-up in 4 others. I was a 3-time runner-up at Ojai, you understand? I was the top African-American tennis player back in the 50s. But when I graduated, there was no money in tennis until 1968 when Ashe won the first U.S. Open in 68. So I went into a profession in education. I ended up as a consultant of discipline for LAUSD. But that's my man right there. I was telling my wife, my 2 daughters graduated from UCLA, but that's the man. The greatest man that ever gave publicity to African Americans. You understand that? That's my man.
As I was walking down the street last night, a pretty little girl came in the sight. I bowed and smiled and asked her name. She said, "Hold it, bud, I don't play that game." I reached in my pocket and to her big surprise, that was Lincoln staring her dead in the eye.
On a greenback dollar bill, just a little piece of paper coated with chlorophyll.
She looked at me with that familiar desire. Eyes lit up like they were on fire. She said, "My name's Flo and you're on the right track. But look here, Daddy, I wear furs on my back. So if you want to have fun in this man's land, let Lincoln and Jackson start shaking hands."
On a greenback dollar bill, just a little piece of paper coated with chlorophyll.
I didn't know what I was getting into, but I'd pop Lincoln and Jackson too. I didn't mind seeing them fade out of sight. I just knew I'd have some fun last night. Whenever you're in town and looking for a thrill, if Lincoln can't get it, Jackson sure will.
On a greenback dollar bill, just a little piece of paper coated with chlorophyll.
We went to a nice spot where the lights were low. Dined and danced, and I was ready to go. I got out of my seat, and when Flo arose, she said, "Hold it, Daddy, while I powder my nose." I sat back down with a smiling face while she went down to the powder place.
With my greenback dollar bill, just a little piece of paper coated with chlorophyll.
The music stopped and the lights came on. I looked around and saw I was all alone. I didn't know how long Flo had been gone, but a nose powder sure didn't take that long. I left the place with tears in my eyes as I waved Lincoln and Jackson last goodbye.
On a greenback dollar bill, just a little piece of paper coated with chlorophyll.
I like that. Here's one looking this way. Let me check it. One more so just like that.
VideoWebb.
Perfect. That's a snap.
Celebrate with Brad his retirement. He's worked very hard. He deserves a wonderful retirement, and he's a wonderful person. Thank you.
But nothing means as much.
Your smile.
Nothing seems to touch.
Your smile.
Your smile.
Your smile.
Ah, if in a third I miss
your smile,
never.
We play football together.
Okay. Where'd you play together?
Jefferson High School.
Jefferson High.
1946. Yeah. We graduated in 1949.
All right.
Brad Pye was one of the greatest centers that come out of Jefferson High School at that time.
It's okay.
Thank you very much for coming.
Come out of high school in 1949. We've enjoyed each other's life over the years. You know, as kids, we've been close together. And I'm just so happy, my wife and I are so happy to be here this evening to enjoy this moment. I know that he has plans. The one thing he told me, he's going to the gym and he's going to enjoy those kids. Okay? So anyway, Brad Pye, we love you. Enjoy yourself. And we'll be in contact with you real soon. Thank you.
Real soon. Really, really soon. Okay. Keep him busy.
Thank you, Sandy.
Great job. Thank you.
But nothing means as much.
Your smile.
Nothing seems to touch.
Your smile.
Your smile.
Your smile.
I've been a thing.
I miss your smile.
Never could resist.
Your smile.
Your smile.
Your smile.
Great man, Meshach.
too. Word to the Brad Pye.
Oh, yeah, I want to say congratulations, Brad Pye. Keep up the good work. Keep on keeping on.
There you go. Coming around, how about a word or two for Mr. Pye?
Congratulations, Mr. Pye. I wish you all the best on your retirement.
Coming around, it's your turn.
Hello, congratulations. I'm Michael's mother, okay? Thank you.
Thank you. It's your turn. What you want to tell Brad? You got a word or two for Brad?
Just to say congratulations. I'm happy to be here.
You got a word or two? What you want to tell? You want to say congratulations?
Congratulations.
That works.
Show us your voice.
We get a word or two for Brad.
Congratulations, Brad. And all the best to you.
Very nice.
Congratulations, old man. Take care.
Thank you much. Coming around. How about a word or two for the guest of honor? What you want to tell him?
Oh, I tell him, from now on, Brad can take it easy and he can just go hang out at Tommy's Playroom and think of some more good, exciting stories to tell. All right.
Sounds interesting to me. We got a word or two for Brad. What you want to tell Brad? Want to say congratulations?
Congratulations. May God continue to bless you.
Thank you. It's your turn.
Hi, Brad. Congratulations to you. Good luck on your retirement. And God bless and keep you always.
Thank you. Brad, buddy, I hope that you really enjoy your retirement as much as I have enjoyed mine for the last 11 years.
Did I get your words for Brad?
Yes.
What you want to tell Brad?
Tell him hello and live a long life. Yes.
It's your turn?
I just want to congratulate him, that's all.
Very good. Thank you.
Thank you.
Did I get your words?
Yes. Congratulations, Brad Pye. You are a wonderful guy. And this is from Ollie Lars of Brookings AME Church.
Switcher. A lot of words for Brad. Got a word of congratulations.
Congratulations. Yes. Congratulations, Mr. Pye. I'm happy to be here. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Brad, congratulations, and I know you'll do well. So keep up the health, keep the health going good, and I continue to pray for you.
Very nice. It's your turn. What you want to tell Brad?
I want to tell Brad that I really, really appreciate the fact he has been such an outstanding figure and a role model, whether he likes it or not, for all of us young upshots coming. We've been watching you, and we really, really appreciate the dignity, the honor, and everything he stood for. And I'm here on behalf of all the younger generation to let them know that. Congratulations. Keep it going strong. All right.
Good looking out. It's your turn. What you want to tell Brad?
Oh, Brad. I just am so grateful to have known you.
We can bring in the man and Ali pretty soon.
I remember when I first came to Los Angeles, Ohio, and it was just a pleasure to hear you on the radio and all the things that you always had. I just really great thing. Coming down to Maverick's flat to see us, the Love Machine, back in the day. Love you very much, man. I'm so glad we're able to give you this tribute right now while you're live and kicking, baby. This is special. You're going to enjoy this. We will, too. Have a good time, baby. Enjoy it.
1931, the Prentice, every 10 years, and with the Pye's Light, we're going to illustrate one of the music from that era.
What you
want to
tell Brad?
Ow! It's your cousin Brennan saying congratulations on a wonderful life and wonderful family. Hope you enjoy your retirement. I know you'll find lots of things to do. But God bless you and much love to you.
I just got the word that this is Pye Brennan.
All right.
Hold on. Quick wheel. Hold on a second.
He opened up pop, which I call hell for my father. So that's when the Christmas is for Howard.
Ladies and gentlemen, I get everyone please stand in the room. We're going to do something that's customary. I think everyone in the room knows. One of Mr. Pye's favorite saying is, switchers, 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 switchers. We're going to switch reels. Being a former state Marine, and bring into the Marine Corps him. Put your hands together. Let's welcome the celebration this evening with the Brad Pye. Oh, you got clapping loud enough in here. This is a celebration of life. This is a measurement of not of the man, but what the man has done around society this evening. Great grandkids, escort the man. Mr. William Allen Young. Come to the podium. I'm a little joke, but he still has all his hair.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, why don't you have a seat? We are going to have an incredible evening. Incredible event this evening because we come together as family, as friends in this setting for probably one of the noblest things that we can do, and that is to honor an individual who's more than worthy of being honored. It's no mistake that all of us in some way are connected to Brad Pye Jr. this evening. Many of us know each other from other circles, but it's generally been Brad who was the catalyst that brought us all together. We've got some incredible things on our program this evening, some incredible testimonies, some outstanding presentations. We'll hear from Brad himself a little later on. We've even got a couple of surprises for Brad and for all of you who are here. But all in all, our purpose is clear this evening. We came to switch reels, one more time, to celebrate the man who created switching reels,
Brad Pye Jr. We had one of the things that we knew we were going to do, and that is to show some video clips of Brad and let you see and hear just the legacy of this man, which spans so many decades and has touched the lives of so many people, certainly all of us here in this room and those who are unable to make it. We've got a surprise coming in, I believe.
Yes, we do.
Ladies and gentlemen, we got a special guest and a special
we ready.
Special words from Mr. Brad Pye Jr. Let's listen.
This is Bill Cosby.
Hello, sir.
This is Bill Cosby, boy. Congratulate you on retiring, finally. don't you, Brad?
Yes, we do.
And see, when you give the people what they want, they'll show up. They want to see you leave, Brad.
Thank you, Bill.
All right. Now, I'm going to switch reels now, because back in the East Coast, it's late, and I'm 73 years old, and I've got no business being awake at this hour. And you need to go to sleep, too, Brad.
Bill, thank you very, very much. You made my night.
Well, I don't know where Tommy Tucker is, but he owes me some money.
Ladies and gentlemen, Bill Cosby Jr. Well, Brad, Bill set the tone for us. It's going to be that kind of evening. We want to have some fun with it, of course. The seriousness is already built into it. The lives that have been affected and changed by this great man right here, one of my mentors, is obvious. We'll get to all of that this evening, but we thought that it would be appropriate if we started off the evening with a song. And it would happen to be a song that is one of Brad's favorite, I Won't Complain. The folk in the church know that song. And we couldn't find anybody better to sing that than somebody. Brad, would you let me do this? Brad is telling me who's going to sing it. Ladies and gentlemen, here to sing I Won't Complain, one of the greatest songs in the church and one that Brad truly loves, we have Bishop T. Larry Kirkland, the presiding prelate of Episcopal District AME Church. Bishop Kirkland, please come forward. Have mercy.
Hello, everybody. Hello. I greet you all in the name of our Christ, and I'm just glad to be in the service one more time, and I'm glad to be here to salute Brad Pye, one of the great men and minds of our time. And I don't know how I got to sing, because I don't have anybody to play, and I think Brad put me up to do this. I was thinking about a couple who had been married 50 years. Somebody asked him, what was the secret of your marriage? And the man said, well, when we first got married, we decided to go to the mountains and ride pack mules. And we got our pack mule, my wife got hers, I got mine. And we started up the mountain. And my wife's pack mule stumbled. She said to the mule, that's one time. 20 feet up the mountain again, the mule stumbled again. She said, that's two times. Finally, he stumbled a third time, and she took a gun out of her backpack and shot the mule in the head. And the husband said, fool, why did you do that? She said, that's one time. She never had any more trouble. She said, Brad, that's one time. But you got me up here to sing without somebody playing for me. But we know a lot about Brad Pye. He's a great guy. But most people don't know he had a spiritual side to him. I was his pastor for a number of years. Brad was a supporter of the African Methodist Episcopal Church, and he still supports the church. And I'm extremely proud of him, because without God, we can do nothing. Without him, we would fail. And with all of what Brad has done, he could not have done it without the power of God. So I came tonight to congratulate him and to say to him, good, better, best, never rest to you. Good is better. And your better is best and came to say to him how proud we are that he has been a model, he has been a mentor, and of course he has been a motivator in my life. I remember in the African Methodist Episcopal Church, they only elected 130 bishops in over 200 years. And I was elected 114th bishop of the African Methodist Episcopal Church. And it was due to people like Brad Pye. When I was elected a bishop, I received a congratulatory message from he and Eunice saying how proud they were of me having been elected the 114th bishop. So we salute you tonight, Brad. And we love you. Keep on doing what you're doing. And keep on serving the Lord. And Galatians 6:9 says, be not weary in well doing. For in due season you shall reap if you faint not. Anybody got any music? Let me try to sing this song. Because I'm used to singing in church. Well, there is music, yes. I've had some good days. I've had some years to come. I've had some weary days and some sleepless nights. But when I look around and when I think things over, all of my good days outweigh my bad days. I won't complain. Sometimes the clouds hang low, I can hardly see the road. I ask the question, Lord, why so much pain? But he knows what's best for me. Although my weary eyes, they just can't see. So I say, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I complain. God has been good to you. He's been so good to me. More than this world could ever be. He's been good, he's been good, he's been good to me. He dries all of my tears away, turns my midnights into day. So Brad, just say thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Have mercy. My, I won't complain. Brad's been through an awful lot, and I have never once heard the man complain myself. And he has had ample reason to, but why? How strong this man, to cover the ground that he walks on, to represent the people he has represented, to do what he's done, and to never complain about it. He is a giant in that regard, and so we are here to celebrate this giant. Thank you so much, Bishop Kirkland. And now, ladies and gentlemen, to lead us in our invocation for this evening, we have Reverend Dr. C. Dennis Williams, who is the pastor of Brookings A&E Church.
Amen. Let us stand together, please, as we join our hearts together. Thank God for this evening. The God of grace and mercy, you are the creator and sustainer of each one of our lives. And you have allowed us to come tonight to show deference to one who is revered, principled, noble, and honorable in the person of Brad Pye Jr. We love him tonight, but we cannot honor and love him without first honoring and loving you. And so we thank you that in your wisdom and in your providence, you have allowed Brad Pye to become the person he is today, and for the one who over the years has remained the same. We're grateful tonight that as you look at his life and his accomplishments, it is a reminder to us that you are still in the blessing and the miracle business. We pray for his health tonight. We pray for his strength, that you keep him strong, that you keep him healthy. We pray that you will continue to bless his family, who takes excellent care of him each and every day. And now as we prepare to break bread tonight, many of us will enjoy our meals when so many around the world have nothing to eat. We thank you in all things, for you do all things well. Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thank you so much, Reverend Williams. We've got a wonderful and delicious meal that is prepared for you as I speak. They're moving forward to present that to us. Again, we've got an incredible program. It is probably good that I should mention that those of you who have cell phones, which is probably all of us, that you make that move probably right now to turn it off or put it on silent, so that once we get into the heart and soul of the program, we can move on expeditiously without wondering whose phone is that.
That is me.
Enjoy your meal, ladies and gentlemen, and we'll continue our program after that. Honored to have one of Brad's good friends and one of ours, Councilman Bernard Parks, representing the 8th District so finally. And we heard that we were having retirement for Brad Pye this evening. He says, I'm coming over. Now, he's got 3 or 4 other things that he has to go to, but he stopped by here first. And we would be remiss if we didn't have the councilman come up. I love this man. Ladies and gentlemen, Councilman Bernard Parks. Good evening. Are y'all here? Good evening.
Good evening.
I just wanted to make sure you're alive and well. I just wanted to come by and wish Brad a great retirement. If you're my age or older, you remember all of the sitcom stories about Overheard at the Tommy Duckett playroom. And if you also remember all of the Pretty Little Green Ones, all of those kinds of things that are mentioned in the newspaper. But what I think we owe Brad a great deal for is that he gave, for the first time in our local community, insight about particularly young athletes at the high school level. He gave insight as to the pro athletes to give their side of the story, whether it was Kirk Flood and fighting for free agency, or if it was Jim Brown, who one of the greatest misunderstood athletes in the world. He gave that kind of information to where we had a chance locally to read about that. Hello, excuse me. To read about that and to know what was going on. I had the pleasure in, for about a 5 or 6 year period to be Brad Grandpa. I told Brad one day, I said, I'd like to go to the NBA All-Star Game and I want to take my son. And he said, I'll work that out, and my son and I became reporters for the Pittsburgh Gazette. And we got press passes, we get to the game, and we had press bags and credentials. We were the only one without a real good-looking camera, but yet they allowed us on the press bus. We went to all of the press functions, until one day we decided to get greedy.
We decided to go out of our seats and go down in the press row at courtside. And so we're sitting in courtside and looking around, and we say, this is not bad. Brad really fixed this up. And so all of a sudden, somebody looks at us and they say, who are you guys with? And I said, I'm Brad Pye from the Pittsburgh Gazette. And this guy looked at me and he says, I know Brad Pye, and you're not Brad Pye. So my son and I picked up our stuff before security came and moved on to our seats. So it was a good 5-year run, Brad, and we appreciate it. We were able to really have a great time as we traveled around the United States for the NBA All-Star. But if it were not for Brad Pye and the Pittsburgh Gazette, we would not have been able to be at many of those inside functions. I just wanted to come out and say thank you for your many, many years of service. I don't think people appreciate the impact that you've made on this community, and particularly giving young sports writers and people that wanted to be in the journalistic profession that open door to where they have an opportunity to now write for all of the major media outlets. When I turn on TV now and see the young sports writers that now are on TV, not newscasters, but sports writers, they all owe that to Brad Pye kicking that door down and keeping his foot in that door so everybody had a chance. And so I'm just pleased to be here. I think we have a certificate, if it's not already been given, but we wanted to give a resolution. I think it's over there, okay, that we did from the city council. And Brad, when you look at that, just realize that although in many instances, city council doesn't agree on a lot of things, but we have every elected official has signed that resolution for you. And I think we're going to give you one of those frames that we don't come and ask for it back, because with finance is the way they are, we have going out and retrieve the frames. But we're going to give you one that you can keep. So thank you very much. Appreciate the opportunity. Congratulations, Pop.
Thank you so much, that wonderful award proclamation that Captain Fox was referring to was on display at the back table, along with other awards that we're going to mention a little later. And it was wonderful for those of us who went by to take a look at it, to see all of the names of all of the city council representatives that signed that. And Councilman Parks is accurate. They will argue all night long and not agree on things, and sometimes just not vote on something because they're so partisan in their thinking. But there was bipartisan support for Brad Pye Jr. That name transcended political parties. It transcended districts. They realized that this was a cause that everybody could get behind. And it's so good to have somebody like Councilman Parks who can spearhead something like this and make sure that everybody comes together to do it. Again, we know you have to leave, Councilman Parks, but we thank you so much for your words and your love for Brad Pye Jr.
As soon as I sit down, I'll probably have to pop back up.